In this video, I will demonstrate the different ways you can view bulk RNA-Seq gene expression data on the GTEx Portal, whether you have a single gene of interest, multiple genes of interest, or a tissue of interest. If you have a single gene of interest, you can enter the gene identifier in the expression menu, right here. Or you can use the search box on the right side of the menu bar. We will search for the gene P10 and press enter. Note that you can enter a gene symbol, a gen code ID, or an ensemble ID. At this time, the GTEx Portal is displaying gene expression data from release V8. This release uses gen code V26, and the genome build HG38. If you enter a gene identifier that is not in gen code 26, the GTEx Portal will not find that gene. If we scroll down, we'll see the violin plots by tissue for gene P10. If you mouse over a tissue, you will see a pop-up dialog that displays the name of the selected tissue, the number of samples in that tissue, and the median TPM. The controls here above the violin plot provide additional options for controlling the violin plot display. The first button allows you to download the violin plot image in SVG format suitable for submission to a manuscript. The tissue filter button allows you to choose which tissues to be displayed. I'm going to deselect brain tissues. The subset button allows you to view the expression data grouped by sex. The scale button allows you to choose between the vertical scale being linear or log. By default, the tissues are sorted alphabetically, but you can also sort them by median gene expression. By default, the outliers are displayed here on the violin plots, but you can turn those off as well. If we scroll further down the page, we will see the Exon Expression header. Clicking on this header opens up the visualization. This visualization shows a heat map of median read count per base for each exon across all of the GTEx tissues. At the bottom of the heat map is a diagram of our collapsed gene model. The collapsed gene model contains all of the exons in all transcripts for this gene. Mousing over, a heat map entry shows the exon start and end coordinates, the exon length, and the median read count per base for that exon in that tissue. If we select a tissue name, note that this changes the transcript expression display below the heat map. The transcripts are sorted by median expression, with the highest expressed transcript in that tissue at the top. When viewing the exon expression visualization, please note that we used poly-A selection in the RNA-Seq library preparation. This can cause a bias of measured expression towards the 3' end. Scrolling up to the top of the heat map, we can view isoform expression by selecting the Isoform Expression tab here. This changes the heat map to display median TPM for each transcript for each tissue. The display has one row per transcript and one column per tissue. If we mouse over the transcript name, you can see that this highlights the selected transcript in the transcript visualization below. Selecting a tissue name below the heat map adjusts the transcript visualization below for that selected tissue. The horizontal scale to the left shows us that for the tissue whole blood, this top transcript is most highly expressed. Selecting the Junction Expression tab here changes the heat map to display median read counts for junctions. The junctions are numbered based on our collapsed gene model here. Mousing over each junction highlights the exons that it joins. Selecting a tissue name to the right of the heat map adjusts the transcript visualization below for that selected tissue. The horizontal scale to the left shows us that for whole blood, this top transcript is the most highly expressed. If you want to see gene expression for multiple genes of interest, you can use our multi-gene query page. We'll navigate to that page using the expression menu. You can enter a list of up to 50 gene identifiers. I'm going to use the example link here, and you can choose which tissues you want to see in the heat map. I'll just leave the default, which is all tissues. This displays a heat map of the expression of the selected genes across all of the GTEx tissues. By default, the rows and columns are clustered. The controls above the heat map here allow you to sort the tissues alphabetically or to cluster them. You can also download the image in SVG format. You can select a gene by clicking on the gene symbol to the right of the heat map. This displays violin plots of expression by tissue for that gene down here below the heat map. We can select additional genes by clicking on their gene symbol. Clicking on an already selected gene symbol, we'll deselect it. If you have a tissue of interest, you can use our tissue dashboard page. We will navigate to this page using the Tissues and Histology menu and select Tissue Dashboard. By default, this page displays data for the adipose subcutaneous tissue, but we can use the drop-down menu item to change that to heart left ventricle and click Change Tissue. This page displays data about the selected tissue, including the number of samples, the number of samples broken down by sex, and a visualization showing the age distribution for all the samples in this tissue. If we scroll down, we will see a heat map displaying the 50 genes most highly expressed in the selected tissue, but also showing their expression across all tissues. So we selected heart left ventricle, which is highlighted in red here. And here are the genes most highly expressed in heart left ventricle. The controls above the heat map allow us to perform a number of actions. We can download the image in SVG format. By default, mitochondrial genes are excluded from the heat map, but we can use this control to include the mitochondrial genes. By default, the tissues are clustered, but we can choose instead to sort the tissues alphabetically. Similar to the multi-gene query page, we can click on a gene symbol to the right of the heat map to show the violin plots across tissues for that selected gene. We can select additional genes, again by clicking on the gene symbol.